Everybody now is saying God is calling me to preach, but understand when he told Saul that I'm calling you to be a minister, I'm making a servant out of you, and not only a servant, but a witness. I'm not just calling you to go and be a witness, I'm calling you to be one. Don't go and just tell somebody about me, but the very life that you're going to live is going to be a witness to the world. See, many of us want to get up and give a testimony and try to witness to somebody, but what God is doing in your life, he's making you a witness. All the hell you've been catching, God making a witness out of you. All the stuff that's been going on in your life, all the rejection that's going on in your life, God is making a witness out of you. God is calling you to a higher place. But in the midst of it, he's preparing you for your destiny. God saved me before I got wild. You know, I was 15 years old. I started preaching at 15, so I don't know about dropping it like it's hot. I don't know about walking it out. See, before I got saved, you know, they were roboting and they were, you know, break dancing. I go out there now, somebody kill me. But those of you that God have delivered from these type of situations, God is telling you to go back and get somebody. Some of you got friends that are still out there. Look at Saul. God said, I'm delivering you from the people. And I want to tell you something. If God's going to deliver you for your destiny, there are peoples that he's going to cut out your life. You trying to drag everybody along. You're trying to bring all your buddies, Cutthroat Jimmy, Shotgun Billy, Switchblade Willie. And you said, look, these are my buddies, and they got to come along with me. They my packer. But God said, you got to cut them loose. If you going where I want you to go. See, some of you trying to drag some folk right now that's dragging you down and pulling you down. I need to hear what Michael said. Get me that. Come on.
Arise.
Listen, you holding on to stuff. You got comfortable in situations and places that God never intended for you to be comfortable in. You've got comfortable with people. Some of you don't like no man unless he's bumping you upside the head.
My God.
Steve Urkel is too sweet for you. You don't want chocolates and love. You want somebody, girl, where my dinner? You didn't cook no breakfast this morning. Bam, upside your head. I live in South Carolina most of my life. And there in Charleston, they have what they call the Geechee folks. And they talk a little different, you know. And the fellow one day saw another fellow beating a woman, he run over to stop him. And by the time he got him stopped, she looked at him and said, leave he alone. He just expressing he love. See, you need to be delivered from that. Come on here, somebody. Some of you have got comfortable with situations that God did not put you in the first place. We have gotten comfortable with mentality that this is the way life is going to be. We all, you, some of you, you own the projects. One building is your whole family. It's all right if you got to stay there, but don't live there forever. Because Grandma Lucille live on 1A. Mama live in 1B. You live in 3C. And the mentality you have is this the way it's going to always be. Because Big Mama been living down there since I was born and you 35 now. God have got to deliver us from some mentalities. Read what Michael said. Come on.
Arise ye and depart.
Look what he said. He said rise and depart. Y'all know what depart means. It say get out of there. The rise means to get up and get out of there. For what?
But this is not your rest.
This is not your rest. Some of the places that you have gotten settled and happy in, God is telling me to tell you tonight that you need to be delivered from that, because it's not your destiny. It's not the place that he intended for you to be in. He told the people, he said, depart and get up and get out of here, because it's not your rest. What happened?
Because it's polluted.
It is polluted.
It shall destroy
you. It shall destroy you.
Even
with soul destruction. There's some of you right now, you've been living in some situation and you are almost at the end of being destroyed. You have been living in it so long until you're not looking for any better. But I got news for you. God has favor for your life. God has favor to put on you tonight. But some of you need to be delivered for your destiny.